Hello guys, and welcome to a new series that one, I'll probably never finish, two, I'll probably never carry on with because I never have the time to, but we're here starting another series that is reviews, but it's alongside reviews, and that is High Mileage Heroes. So I'm here with Chris today, and he's going to discuss about his very special High Miler. We're going to talk about all the details, mods and things like that just now. So Chris, I'm going to spin the camera around and let's discuss what it is. Now I'm going to leave you to guess for the whole video how many miles this has done. You're going to keep guessing. And hopefully you'll be very surprised to know how many this has done when we get around to it. So let's spin the camera around and have a little look. So Chris, run us round with all of the cosmetics from start to finish.
There's a 2009 on a 58 Saab 9.3 Vector Sport 1.9 TID, which is the Z19 engine, 150 brake. That's shared with the Vectra, Alfa Romeos and Fiat's.
Is that the one they call the CDTI or whatever it is?
Yeah, the CDTI in the Vectras and the JTD in the Alfa Romeo 156 and the Fiat's. Don't ask me which models because I have no idea. Can't remember.
How long have you had this for?
6 months. Last car got written off. And the insurance company decided that it was worth about four times more than what we paid for it.
Hey, win-win.
So, yeah, fell in love with this one. Always liked Saabs, always had a soft spot for them, and ideal family wagon.
Exactly. Is this your first Saab?
First Saab.
Oh, nice.
First Saab, and I just fell in love with it. It's the styling, the fact that it's got the black bits, and it's a super rare colour. There aren't very, there's I think 136 of the 9.3s left on the road currently, and out of that I know of about four other white ones, but not in the estate. They're convertibles and saloons.
Yeah. So how many measly pennies did you pay for this then?
1400 quid.
Yeah, it's a lot of car for the money.
And it's got full service history.
Has it? We're not going to talk about the mileage of that though. We're going to keep that quiet. All these little reg checkers over there going.
So that's not accurate though, because we've done about 5,000 miles on top of that.
They're going to add it on to the total now. They're going to work out. Anyway, you're going to still be left to guess. So the cream on black is gorgeous. We'll start with the front, just to say what's been done to the front and walk around. A lot of this wasn't obviously done by you as well. I think you haven't done much to it at all.
The only thing we've done to it is put a few stickers on it. Had to replace the driver's side window because someone hit it. So that was fun trying to find one in the same colour and ended up with a silver one. I'll change the head unit and put a sound system in it.
Yeah.
That's pretty much it, other than general maintenance and a few extras that we weren't expecting. The last 2 weeks have been quite expensive.
Yeah. So he has got some plans to come for it, but we're going to keep that. What we're going to do is we're going to do this video today, and then we're going to do a video in X amount of time to do a recap video. And I think I'm going to do that along with the series, along with all of these vehicles, do a recap at a certain duration in time. So we'll see how that goes. But along the front, did you say it's got a facelift headlight or something on it? No,
this styling wise, other than the lip kit and the wheels and the wind deflectors, and a little bit on the back that you'll see in a bit, it's as it came.
Yeah, so you'll see that lip kit that sort of runs itself down the side with the side skirts. These wheels, do you know much about them? What fitment they are, anything like that?
18s, running 225/40/18, I think.
Yeah.
All round with hub-centric bolt-on spacers front and rear, just to give that clearance.
Are they 20 all round?
Push the wheel down.
They look like 20, I think.
I think the front ones are slightly smaller than the back ones.
Yeah, maybe 15 and 20. It looks roughly like.
Possibly.
Maybe 20 and 25. The fitment's really good, and then you've got that little lip down the side there as well. Obviously the tints are probably not factory, I wouldn't imagine.
No, they should be like a silvery clear.
Okay.
Which is gonna get done because I don't like the smoke lights.
No?
No.
No.
If it was on a darker coloured car, i.e. like black or the dark blue, then yeah, it would fit in, but on the cream slash white, the stock ones would just look so much better.
Yeah.
Look a bit cleaner.
I love the badge. That's nice. Nice little touch. So I'm assuming...
And the sticker.
And the stickers, yes. So yeah, sad thing different. I saw that when I was behind it earlier. That's great. Exhaust wise, obviously those tips are definitely not stock because I can fit my head in those almost. Run us through what's been done to the exhaust that you know of anyway.
Just the tips. Just the tips. Stock exhaust. The previous but one owner, he just wanted it to look a little bit nicer, so he actually did the tips. He had the original ones cut off and then had those welded on.
It
sort of finishes the back end off a bit.
Yeah, it does, and it complements everything of the car with these fuel, whatever you want to call them. Swedish as well. You've got your little roof rack on there as well.
There is a snowboard that goes on there when we go to car shows.
Yeah, that is sweet.
But obviously for everyday daily driving, it lives in the shed.
Yeah, of course. So stock engine for now. Very cool, funky engine bay that goes along with the colour of the car. I rate it, but there is some stuff to come down the line. We're not going to discuss miles down the line, but that is to come down the line. And the engine still, as far as he's aware, the original. And actually I've been behind it and been in it and it runs really sweet, so we'll do a few little videos in and around the car for that as well. But yeah, it's amazing. Considering the mileage, you're going to find out at the end, it is a very, very good car. A full proof of being a family wagon right there with the baby seats. And then look at this boot. What is left of the boot, of course. Nice little boot build on the go here. That is absolutely gorgeous. So yeah, I'll sit in there in a minute and see how this sounds. It's all functional and stuff as well, isn't it? You've got it all wired and working now, yeah. But
it's
still
big enough to get a stroller in the boot as well and a month's worth of shopping.
It's a massive boot, mate, yeah. That's really, really awesome. Yeah, I can probably get around that. Right, so nice little bit of Vectra on the door. And then these seats are anniversary edition, aren't they?
They're sought after. People prefer this interior to the full black.
Yeah, that's really funky. And the seats are very well looked after, considering. It's all
they
very
do
clean.
Need wet vacuuming, but that'll get done in the
summer. Yeah, that's understandable. You can't do it all.
Not so, when it's Emma's daily driver.
No, of course. But yeah, this is their daily driver. And the mileage it's at, again, it's just unbelievable. And the car is really, really clean inside. It's not bad at all. So I know you can't tell a lot from this video, but that engine is obviously a diesel. Fairly noisy normally, but it's very, very quiet. So actually, it's been really well looked after. Do you know what? Seriously, I really, really rate it. Guess a thumbs up from me. So obviously, because there's not a lot to go by for exhaust sound and things like that, we're just going to do a little drive in the car. I'm obviously going to talk about how it sounds, and I'm also going to discuss how it drives and things as well. It's lovely, look at it. For the money he's paid, it is an absolute wagon. And trust me, people that might be saying about fitment and bits like that, it's all coming down the line, and it'll be great to do a 6 month update on it. I'm very excited. It's very clear, very, very clear. Absolutely flies.
good performance for a big car as well. Good looks, very different. And what are you getting sort of as an average MPG when you, because obviously you're loaded most of the time with the kids and stuff. What are you normally getting on this?
After that acceleration, 33.2.
That's good.
It normally averages high 30s, low 40s.
That's good. That's really good.
Depending on the road and what, whether you're up and down through fifth and sixth all the time. Yeah. If you're in sixth, like motorway cruising, then it's low 40s. I think the highest we've had it is 44.
Yeah. It's really good. It's very impressive, it really is. It's very strong acceleration. Now, put all that together, and I'm just going to say one thing, the car doesn't at all feel like the mileage is on. That gives you a hint. We're now going to let you know, finally, to finish this video, or the first part of this video of this vehicle. I'm going to leave you to guess what the mileage is. So we've left you waiting, and we're now going to go for it. Now what I'm going to do is I'm not going to give you the exact amount, I'm going to round it up so it's easy, but I'm going to give you three options, and I want you to actually genuinely comment before I tell you below on this video and tell me what you guessed and see if it's correct. So this Saab, how's it done? Here are your three choices. So here are your options. Option one, 186,000 miles. Option two, 203,000 miles. Or option three, 215,000 miles. What are we thinking? So ladies and gentlemen, that glorious Saab to start off this amazing new series has done 203,000 miles. Thank you very much, guys, for all of you that have voted for the mileage guess on this car. And that has been an amazing start to this series. So we will be back with Chris and his Saab very soon for an update, and bring all your high mileage heroes to me for more videos to come very, very soon. Thank you very much for watching, guys, and I'll see you guys soon.